Welcome, church. Our God has done great things. He's saved us. He's redeemed us. He's been victorious over the grave. Let's sing this out together.
Mercy, you're my help in time.
Church, all the promises of God are yes and amen in Christ. And in times where it feels difficult to cling to those promises, or when God doesn't feel near, his goodness doesn't feel near, we can look back in Scripture and see his faithfulness to his people. He's been faithful to his people for all of time, and we can read about how he's fulfilled his word. Romans 4 talks about how God fulfilled his promise to Abraham and Abraham's faith. And it says that Abraham believed in a God who gives life to the dead and calls into existence the things that do not exist. In hope, he believed against hope that he should become the father of many nations, as he had been told. It continues to say that no unbelief made him waver concerning the promises of God, but he grew strong in his faith as he gave glory to God, fully convinced that God was able to do what he had promised. The passage continues to say that the faith Abraham had in God's promises is ours as well. Because of the cross of Christ, all of God's promises are yes and amen for us if we put our faith and trust in Jesus Christ. In the cross, we are given abundant and eternal life. Our sins are forgiven. We are made new. We have a hope and a future for eternity with Christ. All of that is ours when we choose to put our faith and trust in him. So church, let's hold fast to the promises, for he who promised is faithful. It's our story. We know it in the cross, that we believe in a God who gives life to the dead and calls into existence the things that do not exist. Christ will return. We will be with him in his kingdom, united with him. all wrong will be made right. We will be made new with him to worship him together as a church for all of eternity because of the cross of Christ.
On the day he comes in glory to reveal the fullness of his reign.
Because you came for us and conquered the grave because of our sin, because you took on our shame and you gave us your righteousness instead. So God, would you give us faith to trust in you, to trust in your promise, to trust that you will be faithful to your word no matter what. Would you give us faith to live with confidence, without fear, because Jesus is alive and he is coming back and we will be with him for eternity. And that is our hope. God, we love you. Would we live for your glory? In Jesus' name, amen.
people come together, strange as neighbors, our blood is one. Children of generation, of every nation, a kingdom come. So don't let your heart be troubled. Hold your head up, I don't fear no evil. Fix your eyes on this one truth. God is madly in love with you. So take courage, hold on, be strong. Remember where help comes from.
Oh, 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 oh
His kingdom come.